Oh God, here's another one. They seem to spend an inordinate amount of time trying to debunk misconceptions about feminism. It's almost as if they can't convince anyone by example. I guess that depends on which dictionary definition you like to use, because, for example, despite what many feminists claim, these definitions say that it's all about the women.
And yet, only 20% of Americans say they're feminist, even though 82% say they believe in gender equality. What gives?
That actually makes sense. Those who believe in gender equality don't call themselves feminists, apart from a deluded 2% that thinks the two things coincide. And many of the so-called feminist celebrities are probably part of that 2%.
Is this a question of branding, or is all this one giant misunderstanding?
From my observations of the time you feminists are spending trying to explain how everyone is misunderstanding feminism, I'd say that yes, there is a misunderstanding, but not where you think it is. We are judging, yes, judging the movement by its actions. If feminism is something different than what we see, it's feminists' fault. You can't blame the spectators for seeing what gets put on the stage.
Here are the five biggest myths about feminism. There's the been there, done that idea. Thanks to women's rights movements, women, not all, but many around the world can vote, own property, open a bank account, and hold all kinds of jobs. So what's left to fight for?
Misogyny is still alive and well, which means feminism is still needed. I look forward to the day that feminism is outdated.
That is bollocks. You love the notoriety that comes from being a feminist activist, and you are constantly moving the goalpost to keep relevant. Also, look, she's a feminist writer. When feminism is over, what will you do? Sure, you want to make yourself obsolete.
So misogyny, or hatred of women, hasn't gone anywhere.
There will always be misogyny, like there always will be misandry, racism, and religious fanaticism. That doesn't mean that it is prevalent, and your flinging around the term like confetti certainly doesn't help in taking you seriously. The elimination of misogyny is an unrealistic goal, and proof that you don't look forward to the obsolescence of feminism, simply because you know full well that nasty people will always exist.
And neither has unequal pay. For every dollar that a man earns in an hour, a woman earns 84 cents.
Good evening. Tonight on It's the Mind, we examine the phenomenon of deja vu. That strange feeling we sometimes get that we've lived through something before.
Not this again. Look, there has been an Equal Pay Act for 50 years. It's illegal to pay people less based on race, gender, or religion. What more do you want? If you have proof that this is happening, you are just as criminal for not reporting these people. If you don't have proof, shut up!
And only 8% of the top execs of the 500 most traded companies are women.
And what's your point? Few qualified women have put in the decades of effort to get into those positions. Are you saying that women should be given those positions just because numbers must be equal?
And ending violence against women continues to be an ongoing fight.
You really are marinated in dogma. Ending violence against anyone continues to be an ongoing fight. But you only care for women, right? So much for equality, you hypocrite.
Even in a supposedly equal country like the US, one in five women have been raped.
Okay. Now I know you're just another feminist drone who's drunk the Kool-Aid. The famous 1 in 4 study was notorious for its flaws and wasn't taken seriously by anyone who didn't have an agenda to push. When even these people weren't able to keep it going, more studies, just as flawed, were made because a point needed to be proven, no matter what the reality was. Even the most recent one regarding rape on campus. The one in five one you mentioned is so full of holes that there's hardly any thread keeping it together, starting from the fact that it was a self-reporting study. Self-reporting studies are notorious for being wrong, Ask any statistician that does psychological or sociological research, or ask any research psychologist or sociologist. Also, statistics is a very tricky thing. They're difficult enough where they are accurately kept, like in sports. But when you get your statistic from studies, oh God, forget it, really. They just can't be trusted. The biggest factor is experimental bias. If a group funded by a women's center or correctional institution does a study on sexual assault, don't even look at the stats, seriously. Guaranteed the one has too many victims and the other has too few. Also, subject samples are almost never random, and they're almost always volunteer, which means that in a study of being blue, people who have been blue have a greater propensity to participate and enormously skew the results. Not to mention time frame, environmental, definition confounds, like what parameters defined a valid experience and who is exactly the judge. It certainly shouldn't be those who have an agenda to push.
And 98% of rapists are men.
Of course. Let's demonize the whole gender for what has been done by a few bastards. Tell me again how feminism is for equality. What's the next step? All men are rapists? It's not as if it hasn't been said already by feminists. There's something else about these stats. No sources. In the description of this video, there's a link to a feminist talk at TEDx and a feminist makeup tutorial. Are we supposed to take your word for it because... reasons?
Then there's the people who say feminism is a girl thing.
Well, yes. According to the definition, it's only for women. I don't see why you have a problem with this.
But if feminism is just for women, that would mean ending sexism is women's responsibility alone. And by the same logic, ending racism is only the job of people of color. How does that work?
No, you don't have the exclusive of ending sexism. That is very arrogant of you. People can fight sexism and not be feminists. You seem to think that sexism exists only against women. There are many people who are working to end gender discrimination fighting feminists. So, what do you make of that?
Especially when it comes to ending violence against women.
There we go again. Violence against women. How can you expect us to believe you're fighting sexism when you're so sexist yourself?
The reason why people see issues of gender violence as women's issues, the simplest, most basic explanation is that that's how power functions. And men are the dominant group, women are the subordinated group. And by calling it a women's issue, shifts the responsibility and accountability off of men and puts it onto women.
You are saying it is an issue that affects only women. It is you who are defining it a woman's issue according to the English language. I don't agree with the premise, and therefore I don't think that violence is a women's issue.
So guess what, guys? You too can be a feminist. And as Nigerian author Chimamanda Adichie said,
a feminist is a man or a woman who says, yes, there's a problem with gender as it is today, and we must fix it. We must do better.
Are you saying that MRAs are feminists? Because that's exactly what they are saying. And if that is true, by the symmetric property of equality, feminists must be MRAs. I would ask you if that's blown your mind, but I don't think there's all that much to blow.
Welcome.
Is this the same welcome that Emma Watson wanted to give us? No, thanks.
Some people fear that feminists want an estrogen world order, where fembots controlled by fem-Nazis make men wash endless mountains of dishes. Sorry, but it's just not true.
Don't be ridiculous, that would be silly. But feminists have actually said some pretty hateful things about men. And I'm not talking about the crazy fringes of the movement, as you'd like us believe, but prominent feminists who have defined your movement.
Maybe the real fear is upsetting the status quo?
Status quo. I'm guessing you're talking about the status quo in which male rape victims have to pay child support to their rapists. Or how about the status quo in which women get all sorts of academic support, despite being the vast majority of university students? How about the status quo in which divorce courts literally rip the life out of a man? How about the status quo in which one gender has a choice on whether to become a parent and the other has the responsibility about becoming a parent? How about the status quo in which females guilty of assault often don't even go to prison? How about the status quo in which women get far shorter sentences than men for the same crime? How about the status quo in which one gender is subject to the draft and the other isn't? How about the status quo in which one gender has violence on it taken seriously and the other... So, who is trying to maintain the status quo?
So there's lots of men who aren't doing well in the current system. There's lots of men who are oppressed by other men and by systems of class and race and sexual orientation and ethnicity, all of which, by the way, feminism addresses.
And guess what? Even if you don't identify as male or female, feminism is for you too. Feminist naysayers point to their lipstick and high heels as badges of their anti-feminism.
This myth you have plain and simple made up.
But get this.
If anything, feminism is about giving women the choice to, you know, be whatever kind of person they would like to be it feminine or masculine or somewhere in between.
Except, of course, if they choose not to identify as feminist, ooh, woe betide them. How many people have actually been bullied into admitting they're feminists?
Another misconception is that feminism is against things like marriage and motherhood. Also not true.
Really? Someone should tell these prominent feminists that they got it all wrong.
Throughout the years, feminists have fought against pregnancy discrimination in the workplace and better conditions for working moms. And if being feminine to you means loving liquid liner, take a page from this feminist and go for it.
Whenever you're applying your eyeshadow, think of it like the glass ceiling. The thinner, the better.
Finally, there's the idea that feminists don't look like me. They're imagined as old, white, and middle class. But there are feminists of every race, age, class, sexuality, nationality, and gender.
No. Feminists don't look all in the same way. They all think in the same way. You know, like a religion. And the fact that you get people in a religion from all races, genders, age groups, and so on, it's not a mark of credibility, you know?
So the next time someone says to you, I'm not a feminist, but do them a favor and pass this along.
Subscribe on YouTube, follow us on Twitter, and like us on Facebook.